everybody, welcome to my channel. I'm Val and today I'm really excited to share a thoughtful and in-depth approach to how to find your personal style so you can finally stop feeling lost and frustrated with your wardrobe. I think we can all relate to having a closet that's filled with nice, pretty things, but we're still left feeling really confused about what we like to wear. We don't wear the majority of our closet because when we put those things on, something just always doesn't feel quite right. I know a lot of these personal style videos like to start with decluttering, but that's not the approach that I like to take. Decluttering first can seem like an easy fix, but if you don't slow down and figure out your personal style first, you'll still be stuck in that same cycle of decluttering, buying a whole new wardrobe, and at the end of the day, still feeling really frustrated. I started on this journey of figuring out my own personal style about 5 years ago, because I was really frustrated with my own closet. I was always trying to buy whatever was on sale, so my closet was full of really random things that never really went together, and I just didn't know how to pull together a cohesive outfit. As I started to learn more about my own style, it has been a slow journey. This is something that doesn't happen overnight, but it is so worth it now when I open my closet and it's filled with things that I love to wear and everything goes together. And it just gives me a lot of contentment with my clothes and kind of a quiet, steady confidence in myself and in what I like, and I'm less distracted by trends and what everybody else is wearing. So before we get started, if this is something you feel really serious about, I would really recommend starting a style notebook where you can write down all the things that you're learning about your style. I started a notebook for myself many years ago and I really love to look back and just see how my style has progressed. So go ahead and grab yourself a notebook and get some tea or coffee, because this video is going to be more in-depth, but it's going to be really worth it in the end. So the very first step is to start with what you already have. I think when we're just getting started with our personal style, we can feel like we don't know anything at all, but in reality, we all already have pieces in our closet that we love to wear, and those pieces will tell you a lot about what you like already, and they will guide you on your personal style journey. So go ahead and go into your closet and pull out all your favorite pieces, things that you love to wear and things that you notice you wear on a daily basis, and see if you can write down in your notebook anything that you notice about these pieces. Maybe some colors or some styles are standing out to you. And if you want to go a step further here, you can try on some of your very favorite pieces and write down a few questions about them. So question one would be, what do you like about this outfit? And the second question is, how do you feel when you're wearing it? I think when we think about these two things, it really can help us get clarity on why we like certain pieces and can help guide us on the style journey. So to show you an example, I have two pieces that I pulled out of my closet that I love to wear. So I have this pair of black jeans, and why I love them is that they have a high rise, they're a straight leg fit, and they have more of a relaxed vibe with a raw hem. And this shirt, I love it a lot because I actually made it myself. And I love the boxy cropped fit and how it's really loose and flowy. And this outfit just makes me feel really free, like I can do anything. And it also makes me feel a little bit unique and different, and I really love that. This is a great starting point and it will point you into the direction of your style and it will give you clarity as to what you like already. So on to step number two, which is to start taking pictures of your outfits. The reason why this is a great way to figure out your style is I think your personal style is already evident in some of your clothes, but it's a little bit buried in all the trends and things that you thought you had to have. So when we pull back those layers, it will really reveal what your style is. So after you have about a week of outfits, you can find your favorite outfit and ask, what did you like about it and how did you feel when you were wearing it? And also find your least favorite outfit and ask, why didn't you like it and how did you feel when you were wearing it? So again, for a visual aid, I'm going to show you guys two pictures that I have. So these are actually from 2017 when I was first starting on this style journey. These pictures were taken from the very same week and it's crazy how different they are and what they're telling me about my personal style. So this first picture is my least favorite outfit, and the reason for that is the low rise of the jeans, and I can tell that I was trying to learn how to tuck in my shirt, but it's a little bit off because my jeans are too low rise, and I don't like how this blue shirt looks with the blue jeans. Now onto my very favorite outfit, and again, remember these are taken in the very same week. When I look at this outfit, I feel completely the opposite. I love everything about it. I love the high rise on the shorts and how they have a really loose fit. I love that my shirt is tucked in and it has kind of a flowy, loose feel to it. And the very craziest thing about this outfit is that I still have this shirt and these shorts in my closet. And that is even more proof that when you find your personal style, it really can be lasting and it is something that you'll wear for many years. So as you start taking these daily outfit pictures, you can also move on to step number 3, which is to gather inspiration on Pinterest or Instagram or wherever you like to gather pictures that you like. If you feel a little bit uncomfortable with other people seeing what you're pinning, you can make a secret style board. That's what I actually did in the beginning because style feels very personal to me. If you're really stumped about what styles you like, I've put together a Pinterest board that I can link down below. This has a lot of different styles broken down so you can take a look and see if anything is speaking to you. And we can just look at a few of them here. First we have timeless or classic, which has a lot of button-down shirts and tailored pieces. And this style feels a little bit sophisticated and very put together. You can also look at minimal, which is a style that I'm drawn to, where everything is a little bit more simple and plain with kind of more modern styles. And the colors are usually very neutral. There's also eclectic, where you love a lot of different bright colors and patterns and you wear them all together. And it's kind of a very bold way to wear clothes. Or maybe you like a more edgy look with some graphic t-shirts, ripped jeans, chunky shoes, or leather jackets. So after a week or two of pinning, you can look back at everything that you saved and again, grab your notebook and see if you can write down any styles or vibes that are similar. Or if you notice any colors or silhouettes that are standing out to you. Again, as a visual, I'm gonna share my style boards and I actually have one for winter, fall, and one for spring, summer. Because for myself, I notice I kind of have a different style depending on the weather. So for my fall winter board, there's a lot of cozy knits and it's very casual and minimal feeling. And then if we move on to my spring summer board, it's a lot more relaxed with some loose fitting clothes, some linen, some flowy fabrics. You also have some light wash jeans and cut off shorts. So take a look at your pictures and write down anything that you're noticing, because again, this is gonna help guide the direction of your style. So before we move on to step number 4, I hope you're starting to see a little bit of clarity here and you're getting excited because it's showing you that it is possible to find your style. And remember that this process is gonna take time. This is not a quick fix, it's gonna be a journey, but the more you learn and discover, it gets easier and easier as you go along. So step number 4 is to come up with a loose color palette that you'd like to stick to. Having a cohesive color palette is really important because it makes building outfits really easy because everything kind of goes together and you're less stumped about what to wear. There is a lot of people that can wear lots of bright, bold colors together, but if you're just starting out, it's really helpful to have a base of neutral colors like white, black, gray, or tan, and then to add in more colorful colors to make your style more unique. So go ahead and gather all the notes that you got so far from your favorite things to wear, from your daily outfits, to your Pinterest boards, and see if you can see any colors that are standing out that you love to wear, or any colors that you want to add into your wardrobe. This will really help guide you as you're shopping, because if you know you don't like orange, you're not gonna be tempted by a really beautiful orange shirt, because you know that's not a color that you wanna wear. Here you can also write down if you like more bright, rich colors, or if you prefer more muted, soft colors. My color palette is a lot of neutral colors like black, gray, white, and tan. And then I really love to add in a little bit of like a forest green and a red in the winter. And in the summer, I really like a soft muted pink. Step number 5 is to make a lifestyle assessment so that your clothes are more practical to the life you're living and not for more of a fantasy life that you wish you had. To figure out what kind of clothes you really need, you need to get really practical here and write down all the things that you do on a regular basis, so your closet reflects your real life and is more practical for you to wear on a daily basis. So here's what my lifestyle looks like. So most of the clothes that I need are for my life at home or for going out and running errands. And then I also need some clothes for more dressy occasions, like going out with friends or going on a date or going to church. And then if you want to go a step further here, you can also assess your wardrobe, what it looks like right now, just to see if you have areas that are overrepresented. Let's say you only need to wear a dress, you know, 2 times a month, but you have 20 dresses. This can help you see that maybe you should slow down on buying more dresses. Okay, so now we're on to the next step, which is where everything is coming together. You're gonna make a style summary of everything you've learned so far. I hope that this will give you clarity and show you what your style really is. So look at everything you've learned so far and wrote down in your style journal and ask yourself a few questions. What is the vibe that you wanna give off? Do you wanna be more casual, relaxed, or do you wanna be more sophisticated and elegant? And how do you wanna feel when you're wearing your clothes? Do you wanna feel free and effortless, like you can move around? Or do you wanna feel very polished and put together? What is the style that you like? And you can like multiple styles. I think the best outfits are when two different styles are mixed together. Maybe you have a feminine dress and you wear a leather jacket with it. You know, really mix it up and make it more interesting and make it personal to you. Write down what colors you want to wear more of. And try not to get overwhelmed at this point. This is really just a broad assessment of everything that you think you've discovered so far. As you go on more on your journey, things will be a lot more clear and you'll be more confident in the things that you decided on. When I first made an assessment like this for myself about 5 years ago, it wasn't perfect, but as I kept working on my style, it really became more clear and clearer as I went along, and I feel a lot more confident now than I did 5 years ago. So finally, we're getting to the step everybody loves, which is decluttering your closet. If you're really ready to tackle this, then take all your clothes out, put them on your bed, and sort them into piles of yes, you really love to wear this, maybe you're not sure, and no, definitely not. So things that you love, you can go ahead and hang back in your closet. The maybe pile, maybe try a few things on if you're not sure, that can give you more clarity. But for now, you can put it back, and I really like this tip of turning the hangers the opposite way, so that as you look back in maybe 6 months to a year, you'll really notice if you haven't worn it yet, and that will give you more confidence to declutter it. Now again, if you want to dig deeper into your style, you can try on a few of the things that are a definite no. Pay attention to why you don't like certain things so you can make sure not to buy that in the future. Now I would really recommend just packing away for now all the things that you don't want in your closet, just because you're just starting out and maybe you're not exactly sure what your style is yet, and there's a chance you might miss some of those things. Also, if you'd like to recoup some of the money on these clothes, you can try to resell them at a consignment store or through an app like Poshmark. As I decluttered my closet, I resold a really big portion of my wardrobe, and it was really nice to make some money back from those clothes. In this next step, you're gonna assess your wardrobe and see if there's anything that is missing that you'd like to buy, and also check in your style notebook and see what styles would you like to try and experiment with so that your clothes reflect the style that you want to have. Making a good shopping list is really important here, because as you go to the store, you're not going to be tempted by the cute things that you see around you, because you're focused now on your own personal style and developing the things that you love. So it's a really good idea to buy 1 to 2 basic things every season that you're missing from your wardrobe, maybe like a t-shirt or jean, and a few statement pieces that are really heading into the style direction that you want to have. And at this point, really try to buy slowly and thoughtfully. Don't rush this process. A mistake I made in the beginning is that I was really excited and I wanted to buy lots of things, but a year later I would regret those things because they really weren't what I actually liked. If you go slowly, your style will become more clear to you and you won't make those mistakes as much. And again, don't forget, this really is a process. It's not going to happen overnight. You have to have a little bit of patience with yourself, but don't give up, because again, this is so worth it. When you find your personal style, you feel really confident in yourself and in your own tastes. And I think that really helps you to stand out from everybody else, especially if everybody else is following the same trend. It just gives you a really steady confidence. Let me know in the comments if you're gonna try this. I really hope you do. It really is worth it. Thank you guys so much for watching, and don't forget to subscribe and hit that like button.